trying to look at the distinction between a sentence and an independent clause. And in this case, we have one sentence, because the sentence runs from full stop to full stop, or from question mark or exclamation mark. And you could say there's a natural break, we could make a pause here. But this is a special sentence in the case that it has two coordinated independent clauses that could actually make sense by themselves. So I might be able to say, John left his stupid wife and put a full stop. And I might be able to then say, and he found a girlfriend. And that would make, both of these sentences would then make sense on their own. So therefore they are called independent sentences or clauses because they function independently. They are not dependent on each other. So in this case, we therefore have to find a verbal and a subject in each of the clauses. So I start by finding a verbal, left. Who left? John left. What did John leave? His stupid wife. All of this is a direct object. Then you have the coordinating conjunction. And a coordinating conjunction could also be or. Or but, they always coordinate things of the same kind. In this case, two independent clauses. Over here we have the verbal, found. Who found? He found. What did he find? A girlfriend, which is a direct object. Should we look at the groups as well? Mm-hmm. Because when we have found the sentence constituents, we have to ask ourselves, is this some kind of group, or is it some kind of subclause? That's the choice I have. So if I have a group, I have a central element, a most important word, that is called a head. And if I have a subclause, it's built like a clause, so that means that I expect that there is a verb, and it could also be a subject, etc.